This is the movie on which they first met, Spencer Tracy, man of the people, and Katharine Hepburn, the aristocratic woman, after which they did 8 other pictures together and had a clandestine personal relationship until Tracy's death over 25 years later in 1967. The picture was directed by George Stevens, released in 1942, Woman of the Year. Here's their movie meeting.
Come in, Sam, come in.
Haven't you met Miss Harding?
Yes, yes, in a belligerent sort of way.
He hit me first.
Hello.
It was Hepburn who found the original screenplay and sold it to MGM, insisted on Stevens to direct and on the leading man. It had to be Tracy. The script won an Oscar that year. Hepburn got her 4th nomination, and of course the team became perhaps the most mature yet romantic couple in screen history. The story goes that when they were first introduced, Hepburn said, "You're not very tall, are you, Mr. Tracy?" To which he responded, "Don't worry, Miss Hepburn, I'll cut you down to my size." In truth, however, together they achieve something pretty unique in the movies, an intelligent pair of lovers.
Yes, you are. You can't expect me to move into your apartment.
Oh, darling, I have a lease and everything here is so established, and everyone knows my address and telephone number. Can't you see what a mess I'd be in if I moved suddenly?
Yeah, but I'll feel like a weekend guest.
No, you won't.
Woman of the Year was Tracy's 44th feature, and by then he'd already won 2 Oscars for Best Actor, the only actor ever to win 2 years in a row. He would eventually score up more nominations than any other leading man, 9 of them. For over 30 years, he was Hollywood's most respected actor, yet acting had become his profession almost by accident. He was born Spencer Bonaventure Tracy on April 5th, 1900 in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, joined the Navy at 17, later entered college as a pre-med student, but a professor suggested he join the debating society, which led to acting in college plays, then road companies and stock, where he met his future wife and mother of his 2 children, Louise Treadwell, to Broadway in the 20s, to director John Ford, seeing him on stage in 1929 and casting him in his first film, Up the River, co-starring Humphrey Bogart in his first film, too. Almost 30 years later, Ford directed one of Tracy's last pictures, his 68th of 73 films, The Last Hurrah, about an old-time mayor who loses his last campaign.
The old-fashioned political campaign in a few years will be as extinct as the dodo.
My dear Mrs. Latham, no. My dear lady. Always my dear lady.
Ditto. How do you thank a man for a million laughs?
8 years earlier, Tracy's 4th Oscar nomination came for his charming, touching performance as the archetypal middle-class American father whose daughter announces she's getting married, Vincent Minnelli's Father of the Bride.
I always used to think that marriage was a simple affair. Boy and girl meet, they fall in love, get married.
Based on Edward Streeter's bestseller, with teenage Elizabeth Taylor as his daughter, she married for the first time herself around this period, and Joan Bennett, his co-star from the 30s, as his wife. It's still a delightfully human comedy.
You know what they say? My son's my son until he gets him a wife, but my daughter's my daughter all of her life.
The picture was so successful that only about 9 months later, appropriately, a sequel was ready with exactly the same cast. That's Don Taylor as Tracy's son-in-law, only this time Elizabeth's having a baby, Father's Little Dividend, also directed by Vincent Minnelli.
How about that, Grandpa?
Among Tracy's best and sharpest, however, is also perhaps his best picture with Hepburn, and among the very few American pictures to present a truly equal male-female relationship that works, Adam's Rib. Their 6th picture together, written for them by Ruth Gordon and Garson Kanin, and directed by George Cukor, with the 2 of them married, and Tracy is prosecuting attorney, Hepburn is defense attorney, in the case of a woman, Judy Holliday, accused of shooting her husband, Tom Ewell. A true battle of the sexes ensues, culminating with Hepburn proving that women can be as strong physically as men, and Tracy proving that men can be as sensitive as women. A couple of directors I met who'd worked with Tracy said he had a way of not quite learning his lines perfectly. He learned them, they said, just to the point where he wasn't quite sure he knew them, so that he would sometimes seem to be searching for the words, as we do in life. In this scene from Adam's Rib, Tracy ad-libbed the line about Grandma Moses, and they kept it in.
Well, now, what about that?
That's sweet.
Isn't that absolutely American?
Yeah, you look kind of like Grandma Moses.
With this picture and Father of the Bride, beware of the colorized versions.